said he's been so good. God has been so good.
Good, just ain't good enough. He's been better than good to me.
God has had my back in the midst of
the musical selection by Tamika Moore. Amen. Amen, amen, amen.
Better days.
Amen.
better life, amen?
All right.
Better promises, better hopes.
My Lord.
That God has promised. If you would, I want to thank everyone for sharing. Was there anyone else left that wanted to say something? Maybe had second thoughts? I still have a few minutes. Anyone else had a remark? Amen. If not, we want to get on. Would you honor the God that we serve, the Lord Jesus Christ, by standing as I read our text for today? Amen. Would you stand, please, those who are able? Amen. We're going to read Ecclesiastes 7:1. Amen. And quote John 14:1-2. The Bible says, a good name is better than precious ornament, and the day of one's death than the day of one's birth. Yes. A good name. And Linda had a good name.
All right.
We want to also quote the other scripture. I'll be coming out of John, the 14th chapter, verses 1 and 2. Pastor Powers, every day I went to see him in these last 30 days, he always says, God keeps showing me this verse, John 14:1. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself.
Right.
That where I am, there you may be also.
Yeah.
And where I go, you know not. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not where thou goest. How can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man coming unto the Father but by me. Amen. You may be seated in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Can you give the Lord a praise offering? If you know Jesus and believe the word of God, can you give the Lord a praise offering? Amen.
Amen.
This morning, while I was meditating on the word of God, the Lord gave me the first verse. A good name is better than precious ornament and the day of death. So I looked up Linda Joyce Johnson Powers. Amen.
All right.
The word, the name Linda means a lime tree. Amen. And a lime tree and a beautiful one at that. A lime tree and a lemon tree represents good luck, prosperity. It represents something great. Amen.
All right.
And it talks about Linda meant that lime tree and the roots were deep. She was a tree to a lot of us. Amen.
Yes.
Somebody we could depend on and lean up on. Amen.
Yes.
Linda. Amen. The name Joyce literally means joy. Because she gave us all joy. She gave you some joy. Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Joy. She gave us joy in the morning, in the noon hour, in the midnight hour. She gave us joy. Nehemiah 8:10 says, then he said unto them, go your way, eat the fat, drink the sweet, and send portion to them for whom nothing is prepared. For this day is holy unto our Lord. Neither be ye sorry. For the joy of the Lord is your strength.
Yes.
All right.
The joy that she had, that she gave you, is your strength. The joy that she gave others, amen. The presents, the gifts, the toys, the things she made by hand, the arts and crafts.
Yes.
She gave to so many of us. Holiday treats, birthdays, anniversaries. Amen. She gave. And she made a lot of stuff by hand.
Yes.
Amen. The name Johnson, amen, was the third name. It means the son of John. It was the second most common name in the United States, Johnson. It was 154 in the whole world, Johnson. It was a name that meant something to her, amen?
All right.
And she associated, that name is associated with the number 5 as lucky. But being that she was such a loving and joyful person, we have to double that because she was a 10 in our own eyes, amen?
Right.
And that's why these 10s keep coming up. She left on December the 10th. Went home to be with the Lord. The Lord came and got it.
All right.
And here we are, here on January the 10th.
Mm-hmm.
Because she was a 10, there's no better way to celebrate her life than to honor her on the day and the number that she gave life. Amen. Amen. To all of us. The 10. She was a 10. The name Powers, it has a true meaning of speaking about a poor one. She became poor to help others. She gave what she didn't have to give. She gave to everyone and anyone she could, making presents and packages for birthdays and anniversaries and everything else that she gave to. Easter, especially, was one of her fond memories that she gave to us.
Yeah.
She made these baskets. I still got mine and a lot of other things she gave me. In fact, she gave me this here too.
Amen. Right.
I have a lot of things she gave me personally. Amen. I thanked her. I always used to say in the beginning of the time, I said, Charlie has angel, Charlie's angel on television. I said, then the pastor can have some angels. Amen. So I had 3 angels to start. That was Sister Dree, Sister Martin, and then come my 3rd angel. Sister Powers was my 3rd angel.
Amen.
An angel is someone who has a message. A message of love, a message of giving, a message of encouragement, a message of
strength
that came directly from God through her.
All right.
Amen.
All right.
And we thank God that she was one of my angels I could depend on to be there when I needed someone.
All right.
Through the hard times, the good times, she was praying for me. She supported me in all that I did by the grace of God, amen? And we had a lot of great times, amen, at the buffet, Golden Corral, amen? We get kept in that wheelchair, we get in the buffet, and we have a glorious time in the Lord, amen?
Amen.
And we had some great times, other times too. I remember we were going to a birthday party over at Katie's house with Pastor Powers. We had a great time in the Lord, amen? And she was a diehard Raver fan. Amen.
All right.
Diehard.
All right.
Living the eyes of the race.
Oh, yes, sir.
Like to come on prayer line a little later they were playing. Amen. Because she loved him. Amen.
Yeah.
And I thank God for it. I would call her to find out what was going on in the football game because I didn't have time to watch.
Yes.
And she would tell me what was going on. Amen. I thank God for her
and
all she had done. And I know that name, Power, it means a giving. Power, she's been powered by God. She's been powered by Jesus. She was powered by the Holy Spirit. She was powered by love. She was powered by forgiveness. She was powered by kindness. She was powered by mercy. She was powered by God's grace. Not only was she powered by the Holy Spirit, but she empowered all her family and everybody who knew her. She empowered you for such a time as this that you can keep going on and on and on till the break of dawn. She empowered you and prepared you that she was going to be with her Father, that she was going to be with her Lord and Savior, that she didn't want no more pain, no more pills, no more medicine, no more IVs. I don't want no more. I'm coming home.
All right.
To be with my Lord. Amen.
That's right. That's
right.
And I thank God that she could. She called Mr. Powers late, early in the morning. Then she called Katie. But they didn't understand. She said, I'm coming home. I'm going to go home.
Yes.
They thought she was talking about the physical house. But you talk about her spiritual home in the Lord. Amen.
All right.
Amen.
And we thank God that she empowered us, that we have to realize that we still have the memories that we have of her. Amen.
Amen.
Nobody can take away the memories and all the good times that you have shared with her and she shared with us. Amen.
Amen.
Good times. All the good times we had with her. Memories. The fond memories, amen?
Amen.
Her singing over the phone, she would sing, she would pray, amen. Her night was Monday night. Monday night she would pray after we did our proverbs and our gratitude, always grateful to God. No matter what she was going through, she always was grateful and thankful, amen?
Amen.
And she would always encourage you and strengthen you, amen? And so I just thank God for the honor to be here, to be able to share the legacy of one of my angels. Amen.
Amen.
I thank God that she was a queen. Amen.
Amen.
God placed her for such a time as this in our lives that she belonged to God. Jeremiah 5 said, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. Before thou came forth out the womb, I sanctified thee and ordained thee a prophet. Before she was even born, God knew her, and God knew you, and he placed this angel with a message of love and giving and kindness far beyond you can imagine, and the love she shared for all you.
Yes.
Amen.
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 The God that we serve, amen.
Yes.
And I see here that when I speak of her as a queen, that she was an awesome queen. See, most people have two names, amen. Amen. Some people have three. But when you got four names, you know your royalty, amen. You know your royalty when you got four names, amen. And so that's why she's Linda Joyce Johnson Powers, amen. And I know her purple is a royal color. And they also got the message here. I see that purple is their color as well. And honor royalty today, because we are here in the presence of royalty, a queen, a lady who will tell you to not to give up, but to keep on finding the Lord. Keep on getting closer to Jesus, because that's what she would want us to do, amen? The Bible tells me that in John 14, our text, let not, the first two verses of that scripture, let not, it means you have a choice. But some of us don't have a choice. If you don't have Jesus, you don't have a choice.
All
right. But if you have Jesus, you have a choice. Let not your heart.
Hey.
Amen. Yes. Let not. We need Jesus Christ in our life.
That's right.
And if anything else, you would want me to share with you the love of Almighty God that she had with you on this time to celebrate her life and her legacy, was to see and encourage you to find the Lord Jesus Christ, to get closer to him, knowing that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We might not be what we want to be, might not be what we should be, but thank God we're not what we used to be.
Yeah.
And God's grace and mercy is more than enough for us.
Yeah.
Not surprised by nothing we have done, but he's willing and able to forgive anyone who would accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Romans 10, 9 and 10 does make it real simple. But the Bible tells me here, it says in Psalm 116, 15, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of the saint. She was precious. That means you can't put a dollar sign on how precious she was to God. How hard she labored. And all her good works do follow her as she went home to be with the Lord. Precious. Something valuable. And she was something valuable in all of our hearts as well. Amen. And you were precious in her sight as she showed you and told you. Amen.
All right.
That you were precious in the sight of God.
Amen.
Let not your heart. You have a choice today to suffer or to find the peace of God and to find the Savior that she loved and served all her life. Amen?
Amen.
We all have a choice to make. Amen? And in honoring her today, I have a surprise for you all later. Amen? In honoring her. The Bible tells me that not your heart. You have a heart. The Bible says, throughout the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. God has given us a heart. Psalm 51:10 says, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me.
All right.
God wants to create a clean heart.
Yes.
God saw fit to put in our life Queen Linda. Put in our lives for a reason.
Yes.
And the reason that she showed and shared, and if you loved her as I loved her, and I know you did, that you also have a heart after God. That was her prayer. That was her fight. To fight a good fight. To share the love of God with each and every last one of you.
Yeah.
In one way or another. Amen?
Amen.
Showing love, giving love. And we thank God for the love that she has shown. Let not your heart be troubled. See, trouble only comes when you don't really have Jesus. But when you trouble comes your way, when you got Jesus, you know you're going to get through it. You know everything's going to be all right.
Yeah,
amen.
Yeah,
you know it. Romans 8:28 come to pass, and we know that all things work together for good to them who love God, to them who are called.
All right.
Man.
The Bible tells us that everything's going to be all right. Everything's going to be all right because her battle's over. Her fight's over. She already made it to heaven. Amen.
Amen.
And that's what we need to be glad about. That's why the Bible says it's a celebration of life.
Yes.
Because she's not in pain no more. No more suffering. No more heartaches. No more tears. Amen.
All right.
She's in heaven with her Lord and Savior. Amen. Smiling down and say, I made it.
Man.
Amen.
All right.
And we thank God that she made it.
Yes.
The Bible tells me, let not your heart be troubled, you believe in God. That is a question that we all need to ask ourselves. It's one thing to profess Jesus Christ. It's another thing to give your whole life to him. Romans 12, 1 and 2 says, I beseech you therefore, brothers, by the mercy of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may prove what that good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. God wants you while you're alive as well as he wants you when you leave here. And it's been a struggle through COVID, through all that's going on in this world. It's been a struggle. But you're still here because of God's grace and mercy and his love. And when you wake up in the morning, you don't know how to say, thank you, Jesus, for another day.
Yeah. All right.
Thank you, God, that I'm alive.
Yeah.
That I got a roof over my head, clothes on my back, shoes on my feet, food to eat. God, I want to praise you. And thank you.
All right.
No matter what happens that day, you are still alive because of God's grace and his mercy. The Lord Christ didn't wake you up. It was God who allowed you to have another breath. Amen.
Amen.
And the first thing out of those breaths is those cell phones. Amen. That cell phone ain't going to keep you to give you eternal life.
Amen.
But Jesus Christ will. Amen.
All right.
If you will accept him into your life.
Amen.
He said, come as you are. Amen. Because he says in Romans 3:23, for all have sinned.
That's right.
And come short of the glory of God.
Yes.
And I always said that Paul used to say he was a chief sinner. But I beg his pardon. In my time, I was a chief sinner. Amen. I did everything under the sun.
Yeah.
And then on my road of my life, I met Jesus Christ. And sure, he knocked me down off my high horse.
Amen.
Yeah.
But then I got back up and took on the mantle that he gave me to serve him, to love him.
Well,
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, I slipped and fell quite a few times along the way. Amen. But God always was there to give me a hand back up.
Amen.
And it's all by asking. According to 1 John 1:9, it says, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Amen.
God does not remember your past, neither should you. Because you cannot change your past, but you can change your future.
Amen.
Yeah.
The Bible says in Romans 8:37-39, nay, and all these things we're more than conquerors through Him that loved us. For I am persuaded neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor power, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate you from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Amen. Right.
Amen.
I want to thank God that God has called you today to remember her, to remember, she said, the Bible said, Philippians 1:21, for me to live is Christ, for me to die is gain. For me to live is Christ, for me to die is gain.
All right.
21. God wants you to know that He has some better things for you. The Bible says in Isaiah 55:8-9, for my ways are not your ways, neither my thoughts your thoughts.
All right.
But high is the heaven from the earth, so are my ways from your ways, and my thoughts from your thoughts. God knows it all. He knows before you were born, He knows the day you're going to leave. And if you would tune in to Him and let Him guide and direct your life, He would change a lot of things in your life.
Yes,
you won't have the many trials and tribulations and problems and worries.
Yes.
As you call on your friend to try to help him, you should just call on Jesus. Because He's there for you. 1 Peter 5, 7 says, cast all your cares upon Him.
Yes.
For He cares for you. Amen.
All right, all right.
I want you to know that the queen of your heart, the angel that God sent to you, Linda Joyce Johnson Powers, on this day in honor of her, amen, in this day in honor of her, I'm going to ask all you who are here that are willing to dedicate, rededicate your life, I don't care if you're already a Christian, in honor of Linda Joyce Johnson Power, I'm going to ask you to stand right now. I'm going to ask you to stand and rededicate your life in honor of Linda today. Amen?
Amen.
Would anyone stand in honor of Linda to rededicate their life to the Lord? Amen? Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
If anybody else would like to receive His mercy and grace today, was anybody here who has never accepted Jesus Christ? I'm not going to ask you to stand. I'm going to ask you just to say a prayer behind me. Amen. And we're going to honor her today on this day, on January the 10th. We're going to honor the angel that God sent into our lives. And we're going to thank God for all that she had done and her family and her sons that are here and her daughters as well. And then her husband, her friends, co-friends, and family. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Father God, we just come before you, God, and honor you. Oh, my God, my God.
My Lord, my Lord.
God, we bind every devil and demon
right
in this valley and
all
the hills and darkness of this world. God, we ask your sweet Holy Spirit that lift the head to fall down upon this place and touch the heart and soul of everyone here.
All right.
God, let them not leave the way they came in and they didn't come in right. But God, let them know that you're willing to forgive them and give them a new life.
Yes.
A new way of walking, a new way of talking.
Yeah.
Not to condemn them, but to save them. Because the Word of God says in Romans 8:1, therefore there is now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus who walk not the flesh, but the Spirit. Jesus came to save and to help and to encourage and strengthen you in your life. And Linda would want nothing more than you to have the best that she had. And that was Jesus Christ. Father God, we ask those who will repeat a short prayer. Father God, would y'all repeat after me? Father God,
Father God,
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Forgive us of our sins.
Forgive us of our sins.
We repent of our sins.
We repent of our sins.
We ask you to come into our lives.
We ask you to come into our lives.
And change our lives.
And change our lives.
If we fall, pick us up. Because the Bible says, a righteous man falls 7 times, but rise up again. In the name of Jesus, I accept him as my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
If you have received that prayer, will you give the Lord praise God? The Bible says the angels in heaven are rejoicing over one sinner. That depends on the 99 just persons.
Amen.
We want to thank God for all you who have repeated that prayer. Fireworks might not have came down. You might have got a little goosebumps. You might have got a little sweat. But the word of God is not void. It came out and it touched you. And if you need a Savior, you need help, I don't know, sickness, need deliverance, you need whatever it is, Jesus is there for you 24/7.
Yes.
Oh. And I want you to know that. Be encouraged. Don't condemn yourself, but call upon the Lord Savior who saved us and made a way for us. Amen. Yes. Give the Lord a praise offering. Amen. We have a video presentation at this time. We'd like to ask that.
Never would have made it. Never could have made it. Somebody just need to testify to somebody next to him. Tell him, I'm strong. I'm wise. I'm better. Much better. When I look back over what it brought me through, I realize I made it because I had you the whole.
Joyce Johnson Powers, we commend these ashes, God, from ashes to ashes, dust to dust. We return it back to you, God, who gave it.
Thank you.
Father God, we ask you, Lord, that you would continue, God, to let us remember all the good times.
Amen.
Remember, she's still alive in each one of us.
Right.
When you see her, you can still hear her with your eyes closed. And Father God, we pray, oh God, thank you all the family and friends and those who assisted in this service. Oh Father God, we pray that you would bless them and reward them for what they have done. Surely they have given her honor and great honor in this day, God. And it says in our word, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith.
Yes.
Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all them who that love his appearing, but unto all them also that love his appearing. Father God, we commend this service over to you. We commend these ashes unto you, God. And God, we thank you for all the love, the joy, and the memories. We thank you, God, for all that you have done and empowered us to continue to go. And Father God, my prayer today is that all those who want to see her again will give their lives to Jesus Christ. And you shall see her once again when you get there. Because she is still alive. Absent from the body, is present with the Lord.
All right.
She lives on.
Yes.
In our hearts and souls. And Father God, we just give you all the praise and give you all the glory and honor.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes.
We pray. Amen. 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 Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Amen. The repass is that 1424 East Artesia Boulevard. 1424 East Artesia Boulevard, Long Beach, California. It's at the back of your program, the address. Amen. And we thank God for all those who shipped the flowers and the cards. And we just thank you for the love you've shown us. In Jesus' name, amen. You are dismissed.
Sad to see you go so soon. I know that you ain't coming back. In the beginning everything was cool. Toward the end of it all, it's all bad. I know I played my part in making it what it is.
Hey, how y'all doing?
Do that face, I said I know that face.
What's up, baby? Y'all good? Good to see you.
I'm moving on again. I'm sure that you will understand. I play by the rules, you play by the game. Stayed. It's easier to say, cause I was by your side when you went through the pain. I guess it doesn't matter now that you're so far away. And every day that you're gone, I'm missing you so. I can't believe that you're far away. Can't get you out of my mind, boy, you're out of my life. I can't believe that you're far away. Don't know what I'm gonna do. 4 days and counting, I've been laying and staring myself in the mirror all alone.